Good morning students, welcome to online biology class and today's topic is continuation about the microorganisms. In the last class we already discussed about the types of microorganisms. There are 5 types: bacteria, algae, protozoa, fungus, and the next what we discussed viruses. But on that we already discussed about the types of bacteria. Based on the schedule, there are 5 types we already discussed. And next, in the last session, we discussed about the algae and the protozoa. What are the examples for algae? Examples for algae are Chlamydomonas, and Spirogyra. We already discussed about the Chlamydomonas and Spirogyra. The Spirogyra is going to be reproductive stage at the by the help of fragmentation. Yes, no? We already discussed in the last class. And one more type we also discussed, that is the protozoa. Binary fusion. And next, the paramecium is also going to take with the help of the binary fusion only. In the last class, we saw the how the paramecium is going to be divided at the reproductive stage. And now I am going to be tell about the amoeba reproductive stage. Amoeba is irregular shape. Yes, right? And it is having only nucleus and the vacuole. How this is going to be divided? The nucleus present in the amoeba will be get doubled the size. It starts to doubling the nucleus size. And next, finally, the nucleus will be divided into two. After dividing the nucleus to the size of the amoeba is slowly starts to divide with the help of the cytoplasm and it's get divided. This is the binary fusion of amoeba. In protozoa, how the organism is going to be reproduced? Only with the help of the doubling of the nucleus. The first nucleus will be enlarges its size. After enlarging the size of the nucleus, the cytoplasm present in the nucleus will be divided slowly, and after the cell wall will be knocked into middle and it starts to divide into two cells. That is the reproduction we are going to be seeing in the amoeba and paramecium in the the type of protozoa family. Yes, in the last class we discussed about these children, and now we are going to be discussed about the fungus and viruses. Now I am going to start with the fungus first. Fungus is also a type of microorganism, children. And the fourth type of microorganism is fungus. Yes, where these fungus will be founded? The fungus will be founded on food items. Dead organisms. And moisture places also. Etc. You may found these fungus. These fungus is harmful or not? Yes, the fungus is harmful and also it is a good. So it is harmful, but some fungus are good for us. And next, these fungus, what are the examples of fungus? The examples of fungus is penicillin, bread mold, and the one more thing is the aspergillus. Aspergillus. Here I am going to take the three examples under the fungus: penicillin, bread mold, and aspergillus. Now I am drawing about the penicillin structure. I am going to be rub the board upside, children. Why? Because for drawing the diagrams. This is the structure of the penicillin, and I am going to draw the structure of bread mold. This is the structure of the bread mold fungus, and now I am going to draw the structure of aspergillus. When you are drawing the diagrams, be careful and observe slowly and draw the diagrams properly, okay? Yes, these three are the best examples for fungus, and first one is penicillin, bread mold, and aspergillus. Yes, penicillin. This penicillin is nothing but generally nowadays we are going to be take the penicillin medicines also. That penicillin is nothing but that it is came from the fungus back, fungus microorganism only. How this penicillin was founded? The penicillin was founded from the military laboratory. When at the time of Second World War, so many of our country soldiers have got injured. After getting the injured, they got the pus from the wounds. From that pus, the doctors take and cultured in the laboratory. After a few months, they got a different structure came from the pus, means from that bacteria. That bacteria is going to be create something new. When that new colored of microorganism grown around the old bacteria is going to be disappear. They got that is will be like a miracle, and they tried it and they cultured it separately and they gave that new cultured microorganism to the patients. At that time they are getting recovered. That new microorganism is nothing but the penicillin. That penicillin, which microorganism? That is fungus. Here the penicillin is acting as a good or harmful for us? Good only. The penicillin is a medicine. Yes, right? Yes. And next, bread mold. On the bread, when at the time of moisturizer, at the time of rainy season, when you didn't open the bread covers properly and you didn't close it properly, if any water will be spilt on the bread. After 2 to 3 days, you observe some blackish and grayish on the bread. That is nothing but the bread mold fungus. These bread mold fungus is having some spores. Some spores are there. The spores are whitish spores. These spores will be fall again on the other bread. Again the new that fungus will be grown. That's why it will be doubled fast with the help of the small dots like holes. And next, the third one is the Aspergillus. Aspergillus is also a nothing but the fungus family only. And these Aspergillus nowadays in some countries they are going to be eating. How the structure will be like a drumstick? How the drumsticks will be there too long? Like that, the Aspergillus also will be present. And these Aspergillus in some countries, Japan and China, and not only there in South Korea, they are eating that Aspergillus as a diet controlled also. And these Aspergillus are also having some medicinal properties to cure the some acidity and the allergic diseases also in that country. But in our country, that Aspergillus is not grown properly. But in other states, they are eating, and other countries, they are eating, and they are taking as a food component also as a diet content. Okay, this is about the fungus children. The fungus best examples are Penicillin, bread mold, Aspergillus. Penicillin is nothing but medicinal properties also is there, and Aspergillus will be eaten as a food item also. But the bread mold is a dangerous when you are going to be eat the food. That is about the fungus. And next I am going to be tell you about the viruses. Viruses is also a type of microorganism. That is the fifth type of microorganism. And the fifth type of microorganism is viruses. Yes. These viruses are present everywhere. Viruses are present everywhere. But these viruses need the host organism. It needs the host organism. Host means what? Host means nothing but a substance which gives food and shelter. Food and shelter. Now an organism, if any insect will generally will take the example of mosquito. Mosquito is an parasite, that is the other organism. When the mosquito will be fall on us, what does it do? The mosquito will be take the blood from us and it will be goes off. I am giving the food for the mosquito, yes or no? Like that. And the host, the substance which gives food and shelter is nothing but the host. The viruses needs the host. If the virus wants to starts their growth, starts their circle, starts their life, it needs one host, it needs one person, it needs one thing. That's why the viruses needs the host organism. Generally, we discussed in the last sessions also that the viruses need one organism to start their life cycle. How? Now, our trending word is the coronavirus. This coronavirus will present on the dust, on the chair, on the air. But when you inhale it, it will be enters into our body and causes harmful to whom? For us. If it is in air, it causes to harmful to air? No. It needs the giving the food and shelter. Now the virus enters to our body is giving the food and shelter from them. No. That's why the virus starts the life cycle and it's developed in our body. Like that, it needs the host organism. Yes. Now I'm going to be tell the examples of viruses. That viruses is having only the one structure. The structure of viruses I am going to be drawing now. Yes, this is the head, this was the nucleus, and it contains DNA. Okay, and next, this is the neck, this is the tail, and the six are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These tails are nothing but the tentacles. These tails are nothing but tentacles. With these tentacles support only the viruses will be hold on any substance. Among these the whole structure, if any part of the viruses will be reached a host, it can start, it can rebuild the full organism. Example, take only the DNA will be came out. The DNA, this is the virus DNA. This the virus DNA will be reaches to bacteria surface and it starts the phase, means cycle. That bacteria now we call it as a bacteriophage. Why? Because it having the virus inside, that's why it is a bacteriophage. If any tentacle among the six tentacles, any one tentacle will come and reaches our body, that one tentacle will be starts the recycling of whole organism. That's why even a part of viruses part also is going to be harmful for us. That much dangerous viruses is there in our world. That's why we need to be very careful and we need to be very hygienic and clean your hands properly. You should wash your clothes and properly. You should eat properly cooked food only. You should be eaten daily. Yes, children. Today's topic is going to be completed. And the today's session, we discussed what? About the fungus we discussed and about the viruses we discussed. Fungus examples are Penicillium, Aspergillus, Bread Mold. And the viruses is only having the one shape only. The viruses name itself, viruses only. And next, these viruses needs the host organism to start its life cycle. Today's session is completed, children. And tomorrow we are going to be discussed about the microorganisms, where they live and they are friendly with us or not. And we will be discussed in the tomorrow's session. Thank you, children.